குட் மார்னிங் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், லெட் அஸ் சால்வ் ஒன் ப்ராப்ளம் ஆன் ஃபோர்ஸஸ் இன் ஸ்பேஸ். இட்ஸ் அ தேர்ட் ப்ராப்ளம் விச் வி ஆர் சால்விங். ஸோ ஹியர் இன் திஸ் தே ஆர் கிவிங் எ டயக்ராம் இமேஜ். ஓகே, த்ரீ மெம்பர்ஸ் ஓஏ ஓபி அண்ட் ஓசி ஃபார்ம். ஸோ ரீட் த க்வெஸ்டின். ஓஏ ஓபி ஓசி ஃபார்ம் ஏ த்ரீ மெம்பர் ஸ்பேஸ் ட்ரஸ். So see the look at the diagram. OA, one truss. Truss means a rigid bar, three bars. OA, OB, OC. So three bars are connected at the point O. Okay, that form a truss. Truss means it is used for carrying the weight. So this truss is carrying the weight of 10 kilonewton as per the diagram, right? So three member trusses, three rigid bars jointed at O. At the point O, 10 kilonewton weight is acting. So here in this, what we have to find means, we have to find the tension or otherwise forces in the trusses. Due to this application of this 10 kilonewton load, in the three members OA, OB, OC, the tension will act. Tension, otherwise compression may act. So we have to find whether it is tensile force or compressive force and also the magnitude of it. So let us solve this. This is three dimensional space stress, right? Here in this image, you can able to see x axis, y axis and z axis. So here we have to find the coordinates first. Then only we can able to solve the problem more easier. Let us find the coordinate of the point O first, right? O. So look at this point O. This point is in the x axis, isn't it? This point O is in the x axis. So if the point is in the x axis, it has only the x coordinate. Y and z will be zero. So okay, x coordinate value is given in the question itself, 3 meter, right? From the origin, 0 0 0, the joining line of xyz, joining point of xyz coordinates. So from the origin, 3 meter distance. So x coordinate only 3, y and z are 0. Then look at the point A point. Okay, A. So here A point is in the z axis, so it has only the z coordinate. And also this point is in the negative z axis, isn't it? Yes, it's in the negative z axis, in the back side. So as it is in the negative z axis, so we have to put minus 4, isn't it? Is it minus 4? So xy coordinates are 0 and z coordinate only we have value, and it as it is in the negative z axis, it has minus 4 value. Then look at the y axis. At the point B, so here the point B is in y axis. So here y coordinate only have the value, which is equal to 2, and also it is in positive y axis, so positive 2 plus 2, so 0 to 0. So look at the point C, right? C, it is in the z axis, positive z axis, so it has only the z coordinate, x and y coordinate 0 0 0 4. So okay. So here in this, we have four forces, isn't it? OA, OB, OC and the weight. So totally we have the four forces. So we have to find the force vectors one by one. F1 vector for OA, F2 vector through OB, F3 vector through OC and F4 vector is the weight. So this weight is acting vertically downwards, right? It is parallel to the y axis. So it has only the j coordinates, okay? And also it is towards the negative y axis. So it is minus 10 j. So F4 vector is only have j component, which is in the negative axis. So it is minus 10 j. The magnitude is given, right? 10 j. Then find the force vectors one by one. Force vector 1. Force vector 1 means it starts from modulus of OA, O2A, right? The one vector, force vector 1 is OA vector, modulus of OA into lambda OA vector. We know lambda vector formula is x2 minus x1. as the force is starting from O to A, right? We are considering that the force is acting from O to A. O to A means O point become x1, y1, z1, A point become x2, y2, z2. Just substitute in the formula x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1, we will get the value of the force vector. So here tension value we have to find, right? Tension value. Tension values give have to find TOA. So put it as an unknown value, TOA. So substitute all the coordinate values, then we will get like this. Then this 5 is common for all the numerator values, so make it as common and multiply with the TOA, we will get the F1 vector as like that. Okay, F1 vector have TOA, TOA components. Then find that F2 vector. Then how to find the F2 vector in this? So F2 vector means here force from O to B, right? O to B. So OB vector, modulus of OB into lambda OB. Modulus is, we assume as TOB. Then as it is from O to B, the first point O is x1, y1, z1. Second point B is x2, y2, z2. So just substitute in the formula of the unit vector formula, we will get the second force vector. Then third force vector, third force vector is O to C, right? O to C. O coordinate is x1, y1, z1. C coordinate is x2, y2, z2. So here also substitute in the unit vector formula, we will get another force vector. So we got the three force vector. One more force vector is there, F4 vector, which is nothing but minus 10J, because it is parallel to the y axis and negative y axis, towards the negative y axis. So it is minus. Then so we have to find it. So here while solving truss analysis problem, it is in equilibrium, right? The object is in equilibrium. The object will not move, right? The object will not move. So it is in equilibrium. So we can use the equilibrium conditions. So equilibrium conditions means resultant force is zero. Resultant force means we have to add all the force vectors. Here we have four force vector, F1, F2, F3 and F4. So we will adding all the force vector, we will get the resultant. This is also equal to zero vector. So if resultant vector is zero, means in the sigma Fx equal to zero, x component will be zero and y component will be zero, z component, sum of z component will be zero. We can use this condition also. So here substitute F1 vector, we already find the value, F1 vector, F2 vector, F3 vector and F4 vector. So first add all the I components. Okay, add all the I components and add all the J components and add all the K components. Okay, add all the K components. So one by one we are adding all the I, J, K components. So equate it to zero, because I component Fx equal to zero, right? Sum of all X components will be zero. So I can use this equal, I equate it to zero. So we will get one equation. Then Fy is equal to 0, sum of all yj components, this is also equal, we will get another equation. Then Fz is equal to 0, isn't it? Fz is equal to 0, sum of all z component, that is equal to 0. So we get three equations, right? So see the equations. So we get three equations in this case, right? So here the equations have TOA, TOB, TOC. So three unknown values we have, and three equations also we have. So these are three simultaneous equations, having three simultaneous equations. Okay, TOA, TOB, TOC is equal to zero. So second vector TOA becomes zero, TOB value is there, TOC also zero, then another constant value is there. So third force vector have TOA, TOB value is 0, TOC is there. So you compare with the simultaneous equations, right? A1x, where x, y, z are unknown values. So A1x means the coefficient of x, B1 means coefficient of y, C1 is coefficient of z. So compare this equation with the first equation. So here x means TOA, unknown value. Y means TOB. Z means TOC. So the components, the coefficient A1 is equal to minus 0.6. So B1 is equal to minus 0.832. C1 is equal to minus 0.6. That is equal to D1. D1 value is right side, no value constant, 0. Then second, compare with the second equation. So here x coordinate TOA is not having. So A2 is equal to 0. Then TOB value is there. So B2 value we can find. Then C2 value is not there. Okay, Z component TOC is not in the second equation. So it is 0. Then constant value minus 10. When we are bringing it to the right side, only we can get the value of D2, right? So bring 10 to right side, plus 10. So D2. Then compare with the third coordinate. Third equation. So X TOA component is A3 is equal to 0.8. B3 is equal to 0 and C3 is equal to 0.8 and D3 is equal to 0. So we can use this, we can solve these equations by using the calculator. Okay, we can use equations mode, solution unknown value. So while we are using the standard calculators, so we can use this solutions from the calculator itself. Just we have to enter all the values of A1, B1, C1, D1, A2, B2, C2, D2 and A3, B3, C3, D3. So we will get the values one by one. So this is the answer. So while solving, we got the value of TOA as minus value and TOB as plus, TOC as minus 12. So plus value means it is tensile. So if it is we got minus value means it is compressive force. So here in the truss TOA it is compressive, TOC also compressive and TOB value is a tensile stress. So this is the answer for the questions.